Sports chat. All right, BCS. Did it work? Number one versus number two.
Yeah, it worked, definitely. We got the two best teams in college football playing each other. Even though Boise State ended up beating TCU, they still didn't wind up two or three in the polls because they got the week schedule. So you can't put anybody but the Alabama, Texas.
Does BCS, does Boise State belong playing Texas or Alabama?
They do belong if they pick up some more difficult teams on their schedule. Even that might not help because they have such a weak conference to begin with. But they don't stand a chance when you're playing against Big 12, SEC, Pac-10, Big 10, ACC, all those conferences. You can't hang with them if you're playing the kind of schedule that Boise State has.
Okay, so if it's an and one game, can Boise State play with Alabama right now?
I think they could because they have, they like the trick plays and, you know, what do they say? The sun shines on a dog's ass every once in a while, or like a clock, clock's right at least twice a day, broken. Right. But yeah, I mean, anybody
out of 10 times.
Yeah, out of 10 times, I think Alabama would 10 times.
Right.
But, you know, if you play 1,000 times, Boise State might win one or two of those. So, not saying it's impossible, but
exactly.
very not difficult. Probable.
Okay, so next year, who do we have? What's the preview for next year?
Preview for next year is going to be a little bit difficult because you have some of the top teams like Texas and Bama.
Do the Ducks have a chance?
Ducks have a strong chance, especially since you have one of their biggest competition in the Pac-10 is USC.
Ooh.
They're not going to have a head coach.
Ooh.
Pete Carroll's gone. And I think
possible sanctions, right?
Yeah, sanctions, loss of some scholarships.
Not good.
The thing with Carroll being gone is I think he saw that that team wasn't going to be that great.
Yes, I agree.
In the next few years, and why would you wait for that to happen before you cash in on all your success? But the Pac-10, we got the Ducks have a shot. Other teams like Florida, man, they don't have Tebow anymore.
No, and new coach.
Urban Meyer's
gone for a year at least.
Yeah, at least. Texas Tech is the new coach.
Not
Texas
the right system.
Doesn't have Colt McCoy's gone.
It could be interesting next year.
Yeah, I still don't.
Alabama, dude.
Yeah, they look nice.
Alabama.
I don't think Notre Dame because they have a new
coach.
They
lost everybody, too. Clawson and
the other guy. Yeah.
Tate. Golden Tate. They're both gone. They're done.
Like Michigan, I don't think Rodriguez has them there.
No.
I'd say Ohio State, maybe.
I agree.
Terrell Pryor.
I agree. Ohio State is my front runner completely. I was at the Rose Bowl. From what I saw at the Rose Bowl, Ohio State is a beast. Yeah. Ohio State, Terrell Pryor, he keeps getting better. He could stay another year. If he doesn't do completely well next year, he could stay another year and get real dangerous. It could get real ugly for the whole country because he's the real deal. If he throws the ball like they threw the ball, I heard an interview with Tressel. They said that they interviewed or that they went through the whole Duck practice going up to the Rose Bowl, and they were emulating the Ducks. They played so well with that style that they just opened it up and let it go. Ducks had no idea. The Ducks can't even defend their own type of offense. It's proven that. They're a sieve defensively. But, man, Ohio State is awesome. I would love to see Ohio State. I would love to see Oregon get a crack at this thing. Oregon has a soft schedule going in next year, playing. They play at Tennessee, which is SEC material, but UCLA played up at SEC land last year at Tennessee and beat them. Next year could be real, real dangerous for the Ducks. They could have everything go their way in a soft year for the Pac-10.
Yeah, they have a good schedule. They have two returning starters, two or three. And they have a lot of potential. I don't see anybody really topping that.
Nah. All right. Bam.